about the dragon. I forgot. Oh, what did I just do? Why did I do that?
Nope.
Whoever thought that was a good idea.
It's raining souls. Hallelujah, it's raining souls. Dude, did you just go to sleep on me?
At least pretend like you're interested. Oh, these guys are annoying. These guys are annoying. Okay, welcome boys and girls and everybody in between to Pajama Bottoms and Toast. And guys, thank you for joining me on this momentous and very special occasion as I embark on my first ever playthrough series on this channel. This very young, very green channel that I started a few months back. And if you have recently subscribed or found my channel within the past couple of weeks or whatever, thank you very much for joining the Pajama Bottoms and Toast family. It's a very intimate family, but we take care of our own here. I don't know who I'm talking to. Nobody's probably watching this. The handful of subscriptions I got are probably all bots or something. I don't know. This is just for fun. This is just for me. Because I'm a geek, this is what I love to do, and I'm excited to get this playthrough series started with a very special game that I've been waiting for quite some time. It is, of course, the remake of Demon's Souls on PlayStation 5. It's finally here. Well, it's been out. It's been over a month now. It's like December 23rd when I'm recording this. So when I'm starting this series, so I have had this game in my hands. I have played it. This isn't going to be like a virgin playthrough. Unfortunately, I did try to record this first playthrough a couple weeks back, but due to technical difficulties, I recorded for like 4 hours, and then it turns out the sound was... Listen, I am not great with technology. I'll be the first to admit it. I am like grandpa level of like, I don't know what goes where. It's been a hassle just trying to figure out how to get my camera to talk to my computer and all this nonsense, setting up my green screen. It's been a whole whirlwind of shenanigans. I am a Luddite. I am not technically savvy in any sense of the word, but I try my best. So here we are. Not completely virgin playthrough because I have played a few hours of this, quite a few hours of this. I've taken down like three bosses so far. I mean, I couldn't put off playing this any longer. I had to play it because the game is gorgeous. It's beautiful. It's one heck of a launch title and an amazing remake. Bluepoint, of course, they have proven themselves once again to be the masters of remaking. The masters of remaking Bluepoint games. Can't wait to see what they do next after this. I'm actually wondering if they are going to try and do something of their own. I would love to see what they would do on their own. But if they choose to remake something else, hey, I am all down because so far their track record is sterling. So, but enough jibber jabber, let's jump right into this. Of course, this is going to be a series I call Witcher Souls, because I've modeled my character to look like Geralt of Rivia, one of my favorite protagonists. in fiction, in video games, and novels of all time. I love me some Geralt, that sexy, sexy silver-haired man. So I've created my character to look like Geralt, and so I will be calling this first playthrough series Witcher Souls, appropriately. So let's jump right into this. Let's jump right in. I love the soundtrack to this. Honestly, play this. I'm gonna play this with earbuds now, basic headphones. But if you have the game, make sure you're playing this on a nice with some really good headsets, because the 3D audio in the game, the remixed score, the sound effects. Everything sounds incredible. You can hear all the minute little details in everything that's going on in the environments. From like the cries and the grunts of the undead, to the dragons roaring in the distance, to water dripping down the castle walls. Everything in this game sounds amazing. It is very much a full package, both visually and aurally. It's what they've done is beautiful. It is beautiful. On the first day, I love the reworked intro. Honestly, when I powered this on a month ago, I was like, huh, my goodness, they've done it. They've done it. How did you do this? So yeah. But I am excited to get this show going. Again, this is not going to be a playthrough right from the beginning, because I have played the first handful of hours already several times over. On my first playthrough, when I just wanted to play it just to see how the game was, and then when I tried to record it a couple weeks ago, which I played like 5 hours, and it turns out I had to throw all that stuff out. So I'm just going to pick up where I left off. Again, I've taken down 3 bosses so far. I've taken down the absolute scrub of any boss in any game, Phalanx. That's just ridiculous. I love how he looks. I love how they updated it. I mean, they're very faithful to the original game. But yeah, so I took down Phalanx, that scrub. I took down the Tower Knight. So impressive. The Tower Knight looks so beautiful in this game. And then I've taken down the Armored Spider. So I am just going to pick up where I left off, because I've already played through these intros. So where am I? Yeah, I came back over here to the gates of Boletaria just to, so I was playing last night, and I came over here because I wanted to farm some grass. I wanted to farm some grass. Meaning I was running out of healing grasses. I was running out of healing grasses, and I didn't have enough. I didn't want to spend any souls to purchase some, so I came back here to try and farm some from these fools before moving forward, because I went down to the Shrine of Storms for the first time and I was absolutely getting my ass kicked by those freaking roly-poly skeletons, and I was running out of grass to do. So I came here to try and get some more grass from these guys. Oh, the backstab is so strong, especially with the feedback. The haptic feedback is everything to this game. It is everything. You can feel just the nuances in the vibration when you're stabbing into flesh, or whether you're hitting metal or wood. You can absolutely feel the differences. Honestly, the difference, it is literally a game changer, in my opinion. I'm curious to see if developers do more with it. Hopefully it doesn't fall by the wayside and just become some, you know, obscure novelty that nobody will use as much. hopefully developers do implement, have the feedback, because honestly, I can't imagine going back to regular Rumble after experiencing all the kinds of wonderful innovations that the DualSense allows. This is not a sponsored video. Sony has not paid me Sony has not paid me. I wish. No, I'm in love with the controller, honestly. It's probably the best controller that Sony has put out for a console since the original DualShock, really. It is great. Like the magic effects when you're slinging off these spells, oh, it just feels so good. And it sounds so good. Honestly, the game is impressive. It is an impressive technical feat. I am playing on performance. No, I'm playing in fidelity mode. Am I playing in fidelity mode? Display. I'm playing in cinematic mode, that's what it's called. Should I switch it over to performance? Let's see, I haven't played in performance actually. Oh, that's buttery smooth. That is buttery smooth. This does look quite nice. So usually I play most of my games in fidelity mode. If I have the option, because you know, I don't mind the 30 FPS. I know I'm in the minority, but I rather get me all the visual detail that I can out of the game, because I'm just a graphics whore, and I'm not ashamed to admit it. No slut shaming, no graphics whore shaming. I've gotten so used to playing games in 30 that when I bump it up, it takes me a while to adjust. I feel like everything is just moving really fast. And I haven't really given myself time to adjust to playing games at higher frame rates. Again, I know I'm in the minority in this. People are like, you're fucking crazy. Why would you choose to... But that's just me. Again, it doesn't bother me. But I must admit, but I don't know, sometimes I feel like, you know, the 30 FPS, you just get this cinematic feel that I love in my games. I think I wrote that in a comment somewhere on YouTube, where I'm like, oh, I love my games when they feel cinematic. I'm willing to sacrifice frame rate. And somebody was like, if you want cinematic, just go watch a movie. And I don't disagree, but you know, games can be cinematic. And but honestly, this is nice though. This is nice. Yeah, so anyways, I came up here to farm some grasses, but I'm not getting any grasses from these guys, so I can go back to Storm's End, or No, it's not called Storm's End. It's called the Shrine of Storms. Because those damn skeletons were kicking my ass, but I am not getting any grasses here. Oh yeah, what do you guys think about my character? Mr. Geralt of Rivia. I just called him the Rivian because, you know, he doesn't exactly look like Geralt, but I feel like I did a pretty good job. I gave him the eyes and everything. I think I did a pretty good job. I don't know, what do you guys think? What do you guys think? Look at that. I gave him the cat eyes. I tried to get as close as I could to his scars. The character creator in this is really nice. It's an unexpected treat to get such a robust character creator in a Souls game. Probably the best character creator in a Souls game. Which was unexpected. Was unexpected. No. Yes. So. Certainly, that feels so satisfying. The Spartan kick. Honestly, though, this game is gorgeous. Just the lighting, the particle effects, everything. The fidelity is the prettiest Souls game, which is appropriate. Which is appropriate considering it's the one that started it all. So I'm happy to see that Demon Souls is getting back its, you know, it's getting back its recognition. And it's respect, because it is the one that started it all. But I'm not getting any... I'm trying to switch back to cinematic mode and see how that feels. Yeah, that feels... Oh, nope. Interesting. I am seeing the difference now. Yeah, I'm actually gonna switch back. Wow, have I just been converted? Have I just been converted into a performance guy? Performance guy? What the heck is that? I mean, that does feel, yeah, it does feel jarring going back. Honestly, that's the first time I've actually really, because I remember I played The Last of Us remaster on PS4, and you had the option to bump it up to 60 in that game, and I bumped it up to 60, and I didn't like it. Like, again, I felt like the game lost that cinematic quality, and I switched it back, but this feels different. Like, when I just switched back to it right now, when I switched it to 30, oh my goodness, have I been converted into a performance whore? No, I've always been a graphics whore, not a performance whore. Guys, I'm sorry for the nonsense that's coming out of my mouth. That is what you can expect when you come to my channel. just nonsensical ranting. Like, what the heck is he even talking about? Is he even talking about anything? Is he making any sense right now? I promise you, I do make sense some of the time. Ooh, that was lucky. Ooh, I got some grass! I got some grass! Oh, that's right, I did die over here last night. I was playing last night, and, is this a good first playthrough series? Or should I have started from the beginning? I feel like it's very unorthodox to start a playthrough series from, you know, not the beginning. I mean, I haven't played that much. I mean, I have played quite a bit, but only like the beginning portions of the game, which I feel like, you know, a lot of people have already seen, so. So, yeah. I'm just kind of lazy. I didn't want to go back all the way to the beginning and have to fight Phalanx, that scrub. I don't want to waste my time with that scrub. The Tower Knight fight was impressive, though. Just the visuals of it and everything. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I wanted to get whatever that was back there. I don't even know if it's worth getting. God, this game looks gorgeous. Gorgeous. Like, can Blue Point remake Bloodborne? You know, I mean, I know Bloodborne is... I mean, it doesn't need a remake, because it's not that old, but seeing the visuals in this one, I would honestly love to see what Bluepoint, you know, would do for Bloodborne. I could just imagine. Bloodborne, I think, is my favorite game in the, you know, Soulsborne series, I believe. I love Bloodborne. It is probably one of my top PS4 games. Right there, like right at the top. Yeah, I love Bloodborne. Just the gothic, the gothic, whatchamacallit, the H.P. Lovecraft inspiration of that game, you know, all the Cthulhu myths and whatnot. I love that crap. And Bloodborne was just beautiful in that regard. So. But the details on this game. Oh, he saw me. He's coming for me. In my overconfidence, I thought I could, I was too overconfident in that one. Okay. Ooh, give me some grass. All right, I'm gonna go get my, What should I do? I'm gonna go get back my, goods. And then I'm gonna go back. So gorgeous. See, what confuses me about this game, since it's more level-based than the rest of the series, you pretty much have the option to tackle the levels in any order you wish, which kind of ends up getting you into trouble because some levels are inherently immediately just a lot harder than so, you know. So I don't know quite what's the order to tackle the different levels it. So obviously I believe the Boletarian Palace is where most people start, but again, the game gives you, well, you have to start in the Boletarian Palace, but after you take down Phalanx, pretty much all the other archstones open up, and then you could just tackle the game as you wish. But again, a lot of the other archstones, you know, as you move up in the Nexus, are inherently harder, right off the bat. But it's still kind of hard to gauge in what order to do what. So I took down Phalanx, I took down the Tower Knight, and I haven't gotten further than that. And then I went over to the Stonefang tunnels, and in my initial playthrough, and I took down the Armored Spider, and then that was it. And then last night I went to the Shrine of Storms for the first time, and I just started getting my ass handed to me by the damn roly-poly skeletons. So the difficulty definitely bumps up, but it doesn't quite tell you exactly in what order to do what. Yeah, I don't know. Even looking at this, it's like, oh, maybe this is the order you should do it in. Archstone, or are you just meant to jump back and forth in whichever, or you can just tackle it and just get good. Get good, as the kids say. Again, guys, I'm sorry if I make no sense while I'm talking. This is my first playthrough series. I'm trying to master the art of talking while playing something, give commentary on it, which I'm not used to doing. But, yeah, okay. I'm just gonna go get my shite. Oh, wait. We're gonna go this way. Oh! Let me pause for a second. I am getting a call. Okay. We're back. All right. I'm just gonna go get my junk. Oh, I feel so good. I love the sound. I love the, hats off to Bluepoint, honestly, for the reworked sound effects. Just sounds so good. When you suck up the souls, it just sounds, honestly, play this with a nice pair of headphones, because you would do yourself a disservice by not experiencing the full. That's what you get. Oh, you almost... Yeah, I came to farm some grass, and now I'm having to use it. Okay. So game plan. I'm going to get back my junk, get out of here, and no. Oh man, I do not want to use my grass. That's what I came here for. I came here to farm some grass, and I'm having to use it. Okay, I love watching this. So I'm just, come on. Yes. Ooh, pine resin. I love me my pine resin. All right, go get my stuff. That's the game plan. These guys look so... I love their armor. I love their armor. I love everything about these guys. And look at that. It's just a freaking dope, man. Look at that. Look at the detail work on the armor. Ugh. I almost feel bad killing you, buddy. Yourself. Don't heal yourself. Marvelous. Really? Okay. Feels so satisfying. So satisfying. Ah, okay. Got my junk back. I really want to try and get that thing over there. I think I got it once before, but I forgot what it is. Oh. Yes, I think we can do this. Oh, okay. Oh, good. It's always good. That guy's just impossible. He's impossible. Well, I can't leave without those souls. What was that? Like 2,000 something? Yeah, I need them. Another little detail I love is that the bodies stay where they fall. That's one of those details that I love in games, and it just adds so much more to the immersion. You know, just coming back and seeing your handiwork, I just feel like it adds to the atmosphere so much. Ugh, this game is gorgeous. Gorgeous! Oh yes, don't mind if I do. Alright, let's So I never play. I rarely ever play a magic user in RPGs. But after watching those preview videos and seeing how good the spells look and sound in this game, I'm like, oh, I gotta get some magic in my life. Just the lighting and the sound and everything just sounds like. So, and also playing my Witcher build, I figured I make him a. I made him the Wanderer class because I feel like that was the most appropriate class for a Witcher build, and I'm sort of making him magic user slash swordsman, which is what a Witcher is, you know. So, yeah. Oh, goodbye.
Goodbye. Maybe I should do this stream in Geralt slash Batman voice. Would that be more immersive? If I did this stream in Geralt voice, I can't figure it out. I can't figure out if it's a Geralt voice or a Batman voice. I mean, Geralt. Batman. No. Geralt could be Batman. But, yeah. Alright.
Oh. You know, I took a chance hitting those. It's weird that did. I guess they only blow up if you hit them with fire. I don't know how long each individual episodes are gonna be, but I'll just play until I feel like my eyeballs have heard enough. Maybe I'll try to take down one boss per episode. Maybe that's how I do it. Oh, stop healing! Stop healing! Yes, fall before me. Oh, yes, more grass. I don't know if I like the Estus flasks or the grasses better. I mean, I've kind of gotten used to the, you know, Estus flasks and the blood vials and the... What do you use in Sekiro? I forgot what you use in Sekiro to heal. I mean, they did change that up from the original, where now the grasses actually have some weight to them, so you can't just, you know, hoard and carry, you know, an endless supply of grasses, which I guess balances things out. But hey, the grasses work for my Witcher build. Because, of course, Witcher heal with potions and whatnot, so. It does work for my Geralt build. Alright, Sparky. I'm just here to get my junk. Oh god. Just here for my junk, man. Oh. Now let's lead you on a little merry chase, shall we? Okay, let's go. I do appreciate that they kind of left the AI of the enemies unchanged, which sort of lets you kind of exploit them a little bit. I don't know, part of me wishes they updated it, but then part of me likes that they kept the original, you know, it's basically the original code, right? Running under this glossier, more beautiful coat of paint. Okay, come on. Oh god. Oh, no, how did you...
that, how did you change direction? I swear you were stabbing in one direction and then you just miraculously turned. What? Okay. Alright, let's do this. Oh! Alright, I don't have time to play with you guys. Okay? That doesn't feel good, does it? Okay. Let's stop these shenanigans. Alright. Time to get serious, boys and girls. That is a nice little detail. Did you guys see that? The flames and the foliage reacts when you cast magic. That is attention to detail, ladies and gentlemen. That is look at that. Look at this. That is beautiful. That's freaking beautiful. That's an attention to detail. That's... Oh, really? No. No. Mailbreaker. Added to the collection. I'm gonna be dropping those off with stockpile Thomas in a bit. Okay. Oh. Did you try to kill yourself? You're cute. Nope. Can't touch this. This never gets old. That just puts a smile on my face. That just puts a big old smile on my face. Okay, we're back. Let's try to get our stuff and get the hell out of here. Thank you. Thank you. Gorgeous. Oh, did I? Yeah, I did. There's stuff down there, which I did get. Guardian! Kill yourself. Soldier's Lotus. Alright. We are going to do this. I am getting my junk back. And we're moving on.
Should I try to take him on? Take him down? I don't know if I'm at an appropriate enough level. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that. I don't think the odds are in my favor. Okay, you know what? Let's look at our stuff before we forfeit all our hard-earned loot. Okay, yeah, that's almost 4K. So, son of a bitch. Oh, come on. Okay, guys, I don't know if I'm gonna... Okay, must go faster. Yep. Not even gonna try and fight you, buddy. I know when I'm outclassed. I can take a hint. Should I try? Should this be my task for this first episode? Just try to take it. Oh. No, it's not. It's hitting the trebuchet. Now, you know what? I got bigger fish to fry. Nope. I wasn't expecting you to just do that. Oh, fuck. Oh, what just happened? What was that madness? Wait, who died? Who died? That was madness. Oh, okay. Okay. All right. I'm losing. This is what happens in Souls games, ladies and gentlemen. You think you have control, and then all of a sudden... Everything just goes foobar. That's what happens in Soul King. That's what happens in Souls games. That's intense! Wait, now I am very curious as to what happened to our... red-eyed friend. I thought I heard him breathing, but it's... That is you. You're just waiting at me. Is that him? Oh, no. Let's see. Oh no, that's not him. I thought it was. Okay. Oh.
Hey, what? That's foul play, man. Oh. Every time I roll up here, I get this feeling in my stomach. Like I'm gonna go over the edge at any moment. Hasn't happened yet. I'm really bad at the riposte, so I don't even mess with it, man. What the fuck? No! Yeah, I don't even bother with trying to riposte because I'm complete garbage at it. Where did our friend go, I wonder? Did he go back? Now I'm curious. Huh. He's not here. Ah. Barely made it. Damn right. It is locked. I don't know what's in there. Now that is some good masonry, if I don't say so myself. Look at that brickwork. Look at that stonework. Is it Carolingian? Is it Gothic? Is it Georgian? I don't know. I don't know architecture. I'm just throwing stuff out. I feel like I need better lighting. Can you guys see me? Am I in shadow? It looks like I'm in... It looks kind of dramatic. I don't mind it. So I wonder where our friend went. I really wonder where he went. That was one hell of an unexpected... Oh, look, somebody... I wonder where he went. Interesting. Did he die? Did he die? Is what I want to know. And if so, where is his body so I can go pilfer the shit out of him? I must pilfer! I need... Is that you? No, that's not him. Did he die? Is my question. Very interesting. Very interesting. He did die. What? Oh, man. And you didn't drop anything? Really? Nothing. Nothing. You ain't got nothing for me. Oh. Oh well. Let's give him. Let's pay our respects. Yes. I salute you, sir. I salute you. Ah, Greg, we hardly knew ye. Sir Greg. Oh, hello. Oh yeah, Greg's up there. He's dead. Well, you probably can't see him. We're not of the same world.
Hey, where's your buddy? Oh, did I kill him? Did I kill your bud? I think I did. Also, I love the effects on the particle effects on the messages. Look at that.
So pretty.
Honestly, this whole game is just a technical feat. A feat for the senses. Physics. Look at those fruit physics. Okay, I think I'm good. I'm happy with my. Look at the physics, man. Look at the physics. Listen, I feel nowadays we take these things for granted. We just expect every game to have. I'm gonna die to these scrubs. No freaking way. No freaking way, not if I have something to say about it, okay? Yeah, but I just feel like, you know, nowadays we're so used to games having all these bells and whistles that we just take it for granted, but I don't. I certainly do not. I appreciate all the little details, baby. All the little details. Like his lion cloth. Look at it. Look at the way it moves in the wind, so graceful. Yeah. Okay. Well, we managed to beat Greg. It was in, well, we didn't really. I had nothing to do with it. We'll never know how he died. We'll never know the real circumstances of Greg's death. But, this is just that. We'll just call it a freak accident. But hey, I'm not above taking credit for it. I mean, that is Demon Souls, right? You cheese these guys in any way you can. All strategies are valuable and allowed. See, look at this. Look at this. The bodies are still there. They're still there. Like, honestly, these things need mentioning because these are just little details that just pull you in so much more into the game, you know? It's beautiful. It's like a tapestry of death. Ugh, where do I come up with these things? I'm hungry. I'm delusional. Guys, thank you for joining me on my first ever Let's Play. If you watch this, if anybody watches this, I doubt anybody will watch this. But if you do watch it, and you're entertained by it, please feel free to subscribe and like and tune in. Because I will be, now that I figured out all the technical all the technical shenanigans of running this stuff, I will definitely be uploading these gameplay videos now. I will be doing this on the regular. My dream has come true! I wanted to do playthrough videos for a very, very long time, but I was too lazy and just didn't have the money for the equipment, and surprisingly now I do have the money. In the time of Corona, which is, again, very weird. Oh. These pieces of shite! But yeah, now I finally have the equipment, I can do these things now! So happy! So happy! Watching so many Let's Plays over the years, and I'm like, man, I want to do a Let's Play. These guys look like they're having fun.
Oh,
Is that, oh. That's Roach!
Roach, I told you to stop sleeping on the job.
I really, it sounds more like Batman than Geralt, but, I mean, hey, nobody can do Geralt like Mr. Dog. What's his name, Doug? Doug Cockle? Cockle? Doug Cockle? I feel like I'm saying it right. Yeah. Really? Yeah, I feel like Doug Cockle is Geralt, you know? I'm so used to that man's voice. You know, Henry Cavill does a pretty decent job as Geralt. Can't wait for season two. Season one was, I have mixed feelings about season one as someone who's read the books. I feel like they got some of it right. I feel like they got some of it wrong. I feel it was a pretty good first attempt. I'm talking about The Witcher, of course, if nobody knows what the hell, if anybody's watching this and doesn't know what the hell I'm talking about The Witcher, specifically the series on Netflix. I feel like they got a lot of it right, except for the foreskin armor, which I've heard they're fixing for season two. Oh, yes, I forgot about the dragon. I forgot about that glorious winged hellspawn. I heard we can kill the dragon here. Ugh. It's so beautiful, though. So beautiful. But, what was I talking about? I don't know, I was going on one of my weird tangents. One of my tangents. Oh yeah, I was talking about The Witcher series. Yeah, I felt like the foreskin armor definitely needed to go, and from what I've heard, they're rectifying that unfortunate costume choice. Whoever thought that was a good idea for... Oh, thanks, buddy. It's raining souls. Hallelujah. It's raining souls. I don't know if I dare to. But yeah, the unfortunate foreskin armor was unfortunate. Do I dare? I'm not gonna make this. I am not gonna make this. Made it. Wow, my asshole clenched so tight just now. But yeah, the foreskin armor in season one for the Nilfgaards was unfortunate. But hopefully, I think I saw some screenshots, some early production screenshots, and I think they've gone in a different direction with that, which is... Thank you. Jesus, and or Satan, whoever made that possible. Look at the reflections. Look at the reflections! Ray tracing, baby! This game is brought to you by light. It's pretty. It's everywhere. Get it in your game. Unless you're Cyberpunk running on PS4, in which case, you get Lego graphics. I haven't talked about Cyberpunk yet. I haven't made a new episode on my channel, my episodes that I've been putting out where I've just been trying to cover gaming news. I haven't made one of those, so I haven't really talked about anything that's been going on. But yes, I am Cyberpunk. That's been a whole debacle in and of itself, which probably I want to make a video to talk about it. I'm just going to dedicate this to Demon Souls, but, oh, my video clip is saved.
Oh, hang on. I reached my recording limit on my PlayStation. So yeah. So what up? Okay. What the hell was I talking about? Oh yeah, I was talking about that Nef Guardian armor and season one in general. Which again, I feel like they got some of it right, some of it wrong. Certain characters, just the time jumping, you know, I heard a lot of, obviously if you didn't read the books, I can see the time jumping being a little bit confusing as they were essentially playing out in three different times, season one. So hopefully moving forward now, they kind of unify all the character timelines. And yeah, hopefully season two is an improvement. I think they could improve on what they did. I was happy with what they did, but it definitely wasn't Game of Thrones quality, like early Game of Thrones quality, you know. But you know, the first two books are chronicles, so I guess they're a collection of short stories, so I guess, you know, they did the best they could in trying to adapt that format into the show to sort of tell. I did like that they told the origins of Yennefer, which is something you really don't see in the books, her time in Arethusa. I wish they actually would have spent more time in Arethusa with Yennefer, because I felt like she was probably one of the strongest parts of the show. I think the actress Anya Chalatra did a really great job with the character so far, establishing who the character is. Hopefully, you know, we get more of her in season two. But I'm going to go back to the Nexus. But yeah, Anya Chalatra did. I think the whole cast did a really good job. The actress who plays Ciri, which I forget her name, I think was pretty faithful to Ciri starting out. And of course, Henry Cavill, the one and only Man of Steel as the White Wolf himself, I think also did a pretty good job. It helps that Henry Cavill is a known fan of the series. So, you know, you can tell he knows the character, he knows the lore. It's still hard for me to see him as Geralt because Henry Cavill is a very good-looking man, and Geralt, while not being ugly, because I mean, I don't think Geralt's an ugly dude, but Henry Cavill is too. He's very pretty. He's prettier than Geralt is, you know. I don't think Geralt was supposed to be this rugged look, good looking. I mean, he's rugged, I think. I guess you could say Geralt is rugged, but he's not, like, handsome, like, traditionally handsome, I guess. Which is what Henry Cavill is. I mean, Henry Cavill is a freaking, you know, freaking really good looking man. But what the hell am I talking about? Anyways, Witcher 2 Season 2, Witcher Season 2 on Netflix. I'm looking forward to it. Hopefully they've ironed out some of the things that weren't that great in Season 1. Hopefully now that it's more of a linear timeline, the story will feel more cohesive, and maybe character motivations will come out a little bit more. There were certain characters that did things in Season 1 that I was like, I don't know why. Your motivation for doing whatever it is you're doing. And they've changed some backstories to some characters that, again, I was just like, oh, okay. But, you know, as is always going to happen with adaptations of things, but I thought season one was sort of a pretty good start. Not perfect. It could definitely improve. But, okay, what am I going to do? Okay, so I think I want to. All right, I'm going to try and. Take down the armored spider. I have fought the armored spider in another save with another character when I was first playing this game. But as I said, I restarted the game with my Geralt build, and due to the technical difficulties when I was recording last time, unfortunately I lost all of that as far as the recording, so I built another character build, my initial character build, which was a mage, when I first played this, when it came out, the first week, because I just wanted to play it. I did play with that character, but I haven't taken down the armored spider in this saved game, so I want to do that. That's what I want to do. You know how many times I've died on this thing? More times than I care to admit. Just trying to jump off it or get off it or get on it. I've died so many times. You know, the character motion, sometimes it's a little finicky in these games where you press the analog stick and sometimes they go further than you'd like them to and you totally eat it. There's something over there. There is something over there. Oh yeah, how do I get up there? Oh. So I haven't figured out how to close out of that menu without taking a step back. Alright, so yes, we're going to try and fight the armored spider and hopefully beat him, and maybe I'll wrap up the first playthrough there. I love the clicking noises these guys make. It's creepy. Sorry to have to do this to you, friend. Oh yeah, there are two of you. Alright. Oh, I almost had that backstab. Yep. Get it. No. Leonidas kick! I love that. I love the Spartan kick. All right, I got some grasses. I feel like I can do this. Which way? It's this way, right? Yeah. I got a little bit turned around the first time I came through here. My first playthrough. The stage is very labyrinthine. Just kind of twists in on. I mean, I love this level, but it just kind of twists in on itself, and it's a little easy to get lost around here. But I know the way now. Oh yeah. These assholes! The fire effects, you look pretty good. He just keeled over. Dead. Okay. Look at that. I don't know if that was in the original game, but again, hats off to Bluepoint for the level of detail they put in this game, in this remake. They really outdo themselves. It's just so atmospheric. Hey, let me get that back. Let me get it, girl. Oh, I have that many souls. Maybe I should. I don't think I want to lose those. I've been in soul form for so long. Yeah, that's. I feel like that's the general state that most people spend the majority of this game in. Yep. I know what challenge you speak of, friend. Huh. Alright. Shoot, but I have all those souls. I don't know if... I don't want to risk walking in there and dying and losing. Maybe I should... I don't really want to go back. Yeah, but I don't want to lose those. I don't. Yeah. Yeah, I don't want to risk losing all that. I think I'm just gonna... the music in here is just gorgeous. Again, the remixed, re-recorded soundtrack with the, you know, the live orchestra. It's gorgeous. Gorgeous. I think I want to...
Thou seekest the power of the soul, no? Then touch the demon inside me.
I'm actually surprised her mouth doesn't move, because they did such a great job actually lip-syncing the character models, which you never have that in any Souls game. Usually people just communicate with you telepathically, because nobody ever moves their mouths, I don't think, that I can recall. But I'm surprised that she's still... But the way her voice sounds, I imagine she's telepathic or something. Yes, I seekest soul power. Yes, ma'am.
May thy strength help the world be mended.
Thank you. Oh yeah, look at that Geralt. Look at that Geralt. All right. But you know what? I don't want to drop Mr. Stockpile.
Hello again. I'm keeping a close watch on your belongings, don't you worry.
Let's see, I'm gonna put some stuff away. Check that one out, actually. Talisman of God. What is that?
You have a heart of gold. Don't let them take it from you.
Thank you kindly, sir. What is that Talisman of God? I think I got that when I was playing last night. And, what is that? What am I looking at here? What am I looking at here? Is it a catalyst? What is that? I have no idea what that does or what it is. Yeah. That's interesting. Oh, let's look at the... upgrade that later. Yeah. Alright, let's do this. Let's do this. I'm feeling pretty confident. The armored spider has probably been the one that's given me the most trouble so far in this game. So far, I wouldn't say the game is especially hard, but as all Souls games tend to go. See, that's how I've died so many times. But yeah, I wouldn't say the game is especially hard compared to later entries in the series. But let me not talk down on it too much, because I have had my fair share of deaths so far, so. Oh, no fair, no fair. I was still locked into that animation. Geralt getting his steps in, y'all. Oh, I have to deal with this bastard again. This bastard. Yeah! What are you buying? What are you selling? What are you selling? What are you buying? Yeah, he kind of sounds like the merchant a little. Nope. He kind of laughs a little bit like the merchant from RE4. Dude, did you just go to sleep on me? At least pretend like you're interested. Really? One lousy fireball and I'm dead. No way. Ugh. That slut. Okay. But yeah, he kind of sounds like the merchant from RE4 to me. For some reason. The fat official. You know what? Guys, I got no beef with you. I'm just trying to make my way in the world. You guys aren't gonna follow me, are you? Yes, you are. Come on, boys. Just go back to work. Okay, 1 hour 30 minutes, I think, I've been at this. So, yeah, I probably will try to take down the armored spider and then end the first episode right here. We meet again. Oh, really? Oh my god, wait. Well, see, it's a good thing I used up my souls when I could. Because you never know. Oh. I love his run. I love the way he runs. Oh, these guys are annoying. They're so annoying. Okay. Okay. Alright, we got this. What you guys working on, huh? You guys putting in the work? Mining some of that ore? Let's go. Oh. No. Our sword is broken. We can't have that. Yeah. Oh, that feels so good, especially with the haptic feedback. It's just like, you feel the, again, I think this little controller is pretty remarkable. You can literally differentiate when you're hitting, when you're like breaking wood or you're hitting stone, or it is mind-boggling to me. Alright, sorry about that. My better half walked in the door and I got distracted. So, let's do this. But yeah, I'm really digging the,
I'm really digging this haptic feedback, baby. Okay, let's go. You annoying bastardo. Okay, I see what you did there. Man, I'm going through my grasses again. Okay. Gosh, I hate these guys. Excuse me, I didn't mean to grope you after death, but I mean, I couldn't help it. I just felt we had a connection. Oh man, look at you, sir. You are a vision of beauty. Look at you. Sexy, so sexy. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Ah! It gets me every time. No matter how many times I do it. No! Let me get you in the back. As I said, there we go. Well, if you look to your left, you have the lava pits of death. All it needs is a little work, but with a little feng shui, you could really make this a livable home, you know? And downstairs, you have a wide basement with a giant spider. Okay. Just minding my own business. Oh, okay. I've fought this lovely hairy beast before. Not hairy. Kind of hairy. Spiders are hairy. But so far, the spider's the one. Is the boss that's given me the most trouble so far. Yep, you and everyone else, bud. This is so hard. That's what he said. Oh. All right, I forgot about this back here. Spider stone chunk. Doing the spider stone chunk. All right. Do we dare? Oh, I don't know if I'm ready for this. I don't know. Let me see. Do I have all my Yep. It's now or never. I love the music though, that violin. I mean. No! 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 Alright. I know this. Well, for a fact, this is a save zone. I've experimented. This area before. Unfortunately, I can still get hit by these guys. So, I think we're gonna start with, Take top shots. Range. wants to kill you. I should have bought some of those what are they called? The magic regenerating thingamajigs. Oh, I have the Soul of the Tower Knight and I haven't used it? But you know what? I don't want to spend any unnecessary souls. I think I can do this. like that you can use magic once again. I like that magic is a viable option.
Magic is a viable option.
You know, because they totally nerfed they nerfed it in the later games. So I like that. It's totally a usable tactic. I feel bad for all you mage lovers out there in the later games, because they totally did not do right by you. Did not do right by you. Okay, let's go. We've done this song and dance. Oh, what did I just do? Why did I do that? I hate that those damn fireballs track you. Like, what? Freaking homing missile fireballs, man. Well, at least I didn't lose much. At least I didn't lose too many souls. Although I am running, I'm down to my good grasses. And I am not happy about that. I wanted to save those for a special occasion. Kupika! Oh, you mother banger! No! I didn't do anything to you, sir. Go back to your day job! At least the trek back to the damn spider isn't too long, but I hate that I have to. I hate that I have to continually go up against this dude. We got this, Geralt. We've fought worse monsters than this. Oh, look at that. Okay. I should. I'm gonna load up some of those, I don't know, some of these throwing knives. See how effective they are. Because I don't know how effective the fire bombs are gonna be, given that it's a fire spider. Huh? Didn't get me this time. No, no, no. Oh, damn. Yeah, forgot to, It's always good practice in this battle that you have to repeatedly go down the elevator to send the elevator back up in case of your untimely demise. Ooh, you're walking on air, sir. It's always good practice to send it back up once you get to the bottom, just in case you should die, and then you'd have to... Pro tips. It appears mobile. What do you mean? Oh no, I have to. There we go. What's on there? Just a black pit of death? Okay. Oh, again, I love the I love the soundtrack. Oh no. I lost my internet connection. What in the world? Okay, we're just gonna, you know what? I'm not gonna deal with that. Oh, excuse me. Oh, that was nasty. I got some over my arm. No, that was bogus. Okay, we are just... Yes, I'm gonna stay offline for now because I don't want to, I don't want to risk being interrupted in the middle of a fight! Okay, well at least I'm back here. Okay. Oh, but... It restarted me, but it didn't, it didn't reset my... My health or my magic. Oh my gosh. Thank you. I forgot about that. It's a really pretty effect, though. When you think you have enough time to get off that one heel. Son of a ball. It's okay, Geralt. We got this, baby. We fought arachnids before. Kikimoras, Strigas, Wyverns. Arachne. We got this. I've been in soul form for so long. This guy always gets it. I feel bad. It's a compulsory thing just to always stab that one in the back. I know I don't have to do it, but you know. It's a great way to release some pressure, some frustration, you know, at how badly I'm sucking. But yeah, so far the armored spiders been my biggest problem. Hey, I'm out of practice, okay? I haven't played a Souls game in a while. I forget how slow and methodical you have to be with these, you know? I got used to playing Bloodborne and Sekiro, where it was all just like... So, yeah. Forget that the mantra of these games is slow and steady. Slow and steady. But, over to your right, you have the pit of death. Oh no, where's my backstab? Here's my backstab. And then we have some beautiful spider webs that are perfect for any occasion.
And down we go into the mines. Into the pit we go. Into the pit of fire. Into the ring of fire.
Okay, let's do this, Mama Chula. Let's do this, Mommy. Oh, you didn't get me that time. Just gonna help the walk. Come on, those pip-pips! Jeez, I'm sure she got your grasses out. All those little grasses. Her creeper. Oh. Oh, that was lucky. That was so lucky. That get me. Back in corporeal form, eh? I love it. Take that, you sassy little slut. I'm not slut shaming, spider shaming, but does that feel good? Look at how my fire sword lights up the strands of web. I mean, again, the attention to detail in this game. Look at the lighting just gently flowing in from the cave openings. As if to say, you've done it, son. Well done. Oh yes, I love me those renowned warrior souls. Okay guys, we did it! I know you were waiting with bated, you were watching with bated breath to see what would happen. Alright. Alright, I think that'll do it. I think that'll do it for this first episode. And then we will continue on. But thank you so much for joining me on this first playthrough series, Adventure Shenanigans in Demon Souls, my first playthrough series on my channel. If you like what you see, consider subscribing. And come on in and have a good time, all right? Well, I'm gonna return to the Nexus. so I can upgrade Mr. Geralt, but I will be doing that next time. I'm gonna try to upload these because I really want to keep playing this game, so these are gonna be very frequent uploads. So again, I won't keep my public waiting. No, but I really just want to play this game as much as I can, because, I mean, gosh darn it, it's such a beautiful game. I mean, look at this. It is such a beautiful game. This is the best looking Souls game right now. Funny enough, it was, oh, look at that. Is she looking up at me? Is she looking up at me? Is she following me? Is she following me? Wait, I gotta see this. No, I think she was just looking up. I thought she was actually following me with her. Anyways. So I'm just so impressed by the detail in this game. I love it. I love the sound when you walk around here. Ugh. So gorgeous. So gorgeous. Alright. Anyways, I gotta stop. If not, I will go on for another 5.5 hours. I've done it before. Once again, guys, thank you for watching and all that jazz. I'll catch you all later, Gators. Alright, boys and girls and everybody in between, you all have yourselves a beautiful day, and we'll see each other again. Peace out.